In his newsrooms in 2013, the board of direction of IBM Corporation presented its new communication devices that intend to engage all key stakeholders in the process of innovation. Whether they are employees, customers, or partners, they can participate to accelerate innovation and deliver results. The strategy of IBM Corporation undoubtedly depicts a new trend. Stakeholders are increasingly considered as efficient resources to dynamize the process of innovation. And the case of IBM is not isolated. Many study cases analyze the accuracy of Freeman's hypothesis. The more stakeholder engagement you have, the more innovation you get. It confirms that the correlation is real. Yet the process, that is to say, the how, remains unclear. But to understand the complexity of stakeholder engagement when it comes to innovation, let me tell you a little bit about the process. Everyone in these rooms knows the traditional innovation process. We can picture it as an arrow, which constitutes what we call the research and development department. The idea comes from the brainstorm between researcher, then it becomes a prototype, and then the test phase, and step by step, it goes right towards the production sector. Easy, right? Yet, if you want to engage employee, consumers, manager, and all key stakeholders at the same time, things get way more complicated. Because it is not as easy as the more stakeholder engagement you have, the more innovation you get. In reality, if some stakeholders are engaged, others are losing power and bring less innovation. If consumers are bringing their point of view every time, others will lose time for innovation to manage the flux of information. Stakeholder engagement is like a circle where every opposite point hamper each other innovation at its center. That's where we understood we were unable to picture innovation in a stakeholder engaged context. But it was too abstract for all of us. So we decided to study this aspect of stakeholders. How does a firm concretely innovate from stakeholders? And is it possible to establish a unique model for most companies? Anyway, we have many explanations of the existence of this strong link between stakeholder engagement and innovation. Yet, the how is the problem. This is the real question we had to answer. We decided to lead a qualitative study since we're studying a complex and evolving process. Our fieldwork consisted in exploring the how of the phenomenon. We would ask open questions about stakeholder engagement to people interviewed, letting them answer what they thought it was about. We asked them about the process of innovation in their firm. From their answer, we could draw meaningful conclusions, comparing the different interviews. We decided to focus on the food processing industry. So we started our study with Michel Augustin. Laura Teresi, headmaster in our region, answered our questions. It is a very original French startup which has recently skyrocketed. They developed an innovative approach of business which engage way more stakeholders than the other companies of food sector. They are really active on social networks. They share crazy photos of them. They invite consumers to degustations and throw more responsibilities on employees. It is not a surprise that such a company has success. With all the tools that digitalization has brought about, it is way more easy to take into consideration more stakeholders. It seems quite revolutionary, but maybe innovation is not monopolized by specialists anymore. And it starts with consumers. Consumer engagement can be at the center of the innovation process by bringing their feedbacks to companies. At Michel and Augustin, they created the concept of the bananerie shop, which is based on their sincere convictions that entrepreneurship has a great potential in leading to innovation. And they don't only count on their employees in this firm. Consumers are other key stakeholders to them. Indeed, every first Thursday of every month, each Bananeray opens its door to the public. So consumers come and give their feedbacks about new products. They also are really willing to let comments on the social networks pages of Michelin Augustin. This way, not only it helps the company to innovate, but it also creates a real connection between business world and consumers. Isn't it genius? Likewise, employee empowerment undoubtedly pictures that employee can double the work normally attributed to researcher. It is quite logical. You give employees more access to innovation. It brings obviously more innovation. This is exactly the experience related by Michel and Augustin. Employee contribution is nurtured and bolstered. All employees are encouraged to participate in the innovation process. They create and test new recipes. And look at their faces. Doesn't they seem crazy? Yeah, a little bit. But in this atmosphere, and because they feel empowered by the company, they are really willing to create new recipes, which means innovation. All team working at every Bananeray has to pass a baking NVQ. So the whole company is qualified to participate to the innovation process with new recipes, thanks to the formation Michel and Augustin authored them. Here, managers bet on information to have all their employees invested in the process of innovation. Now that we have circled the phenomenon and what companies have to win for their innovation process, we had to figure out what the firms concretely needed to do, involving each stakeholder at every step of the innovation process. First, the multidisciplinary teams, meetings where workers from every sector is taken into account. We met Jean-Louis Compo, manager from SEB, the famous and successful company producing kitchen tools, and a lot of other things. First, he thinks it allows every worker's conception of the product to evolve, so it also brings evolution to the product. Moreover, it also entitles a synchronization within the conception. Indeed, as Mr. Compo told us, a technicist will see it big but quiet during utilization, whereas a designer will see it smaller to have it more practical. It seems that this convergence brings about a clearer and more viable project than traditional projects from research and development department. Stakeholder engagement reduces massively the round trip between designers and engineers. Of course, you can't make such meetings if you don't have a special room where to implement this new way of work. This is why SEB implemented the SEB Lab that you can see on this picture. SEB launched one of the first FEB Lab of France, which is paradoxically located in Compiègne. They called it the SEB Lab, where an innovative innovation process takes place. A room quite small, where employees from every sector are invited to work on projects in multidisciplinary teams. And employees are very motivated to take part in these activities. Mr. Compo, which is responsible for the SEB Lab, explained that these teams work from the brainstorm to the prototype. Put a decanter on the 3D printing and you will see what happens. You will love it. Even in a company like Bonduelle, which produces frozen food and cans, they are thinking about implementing such strategies through the opening of their innovation center. We met Tatiana Lamy, brand marketing director of Bonduelle, Fresh France. She clearly thinks it can bring about a new lease of life to the company. Yet the way they could implement it is unclear. They are very careful not to disturb their traditional innovation process which is efficient, knowing that innovation is not Baudrillard's first priority. And here we had another aspect of stakeholder engagement within firms that we had to explore. It is paradoxically positive and negative at the same time. Companies like Michel and Augustin have outstanding results with the stakeholders engaged strategies on their innovation, but also on their brand image. It seduces consumers. But on the other hand, companies like Bonduelle sees more stakeholders' engagement as a way to enhance brand image of the firm. It is important to notice that this process does not replace the traditional R&D process. For example, with the SEB Lab, for now, ideas still come from the R&D department. Mr. Kumpo presented it as you can see on the screen. Innovation comes from R&D departments, makes a loop, and then go back to the R&D department for further research. The SEB Lab remains a very small room of the R&D department. It is still at an experimental level and doesn't have the ambition to grow. It is efficient as long as it remains small. The idea is to have a spirit of work of a startup, but within a big company, told us Mr. Compo. And this is where we understood the scale of the changes that stakeholder innovation, stakeholder process can engage. When you read papers about stakeholder engagement, you can be very enthusiastic, thinking it is the next step of innovation. Yet, the companies we met have a different approach of the phenomenon, more pragmatic. These new strategies are developed to complement the traditional process, not to replace it. The how of stakeholder engaged process remains a small part of the how of the traditional process. It just enhances it. But what we discovered is not limited to consumers' and employees' empowerment or disciplinary meetings. Atmosphere at the company, role of managers, open space, and open innovation. All of these ideas depict a new way that go further than only a modification of innovation process. Rather than replacing the traditional process, the idea of the new ones embodies a new way to conceive the firm, where cooperation is reinforced and firms' interest closer to external stakeholder interests. It has already affected mentalities, relationships, and strategy within firms. As Freeman pictured it, if stakeholder engagement can create a new way to conceive business in this world, we discovered along our research that specifically in the area of innovation, stakeholder engagement can bring about a new lease of life to the process, enhancing brand image and at the same time create a nicer atmosphere at work. Stakeholder innovation amid innovation, that is an idea worth planning.